The Riversing Lights circuit is very simple. It consists of one or two rear lights operated by a switch mounted on the gearbox. The switch is automatically operated when reverse gear is selected. There are two types of riversing lights failures. Failure number one, the riversing lights do not light up. Failure number two, the riversing lights are always on. The most common problem with riversing lights that do not light up is a blown bulb. Check the riversing light bulb. Test the bulb across the battery terminals. The bulb is good. If none of the two bulbs light up, you should suspect a blown fuse. If the fuse blows as soon as you select reverse gear, there is a short circuit between the switch and reversing lights. Most often, the fuse protecting the reversing lights also covers other accessories. If none of the other accessories is working, check the fuse. The fuse is good. If the fuse is good, check that current is reaching the bulb holder. Connect a test lamp to an earth point. Check the connection of the test lamp. Switch on ignition. Select reverse gear. Test the plus on the bulb holder. If the test lamp lights, there is a false contact on the bulb holder. If the test lamp doesn't light, check that current reaches the connector. If the test lamp lights, current is reaching the connector. The test lamp lights, current is reaching the connector. Switch off the ignition. If no current is reaching the bulb, the fault may be due to a false contact on the connector. Tighten the connector terminal and test again. Turn the ignition on. Select reverse gear. If the test lamp lights, there is a false contact on the bulb holder. If the test lamp doesn't light, change the bulb holder plate and if necessary the connector. Imagine that current is not reaching the connector. There are two possibilities of failure along the rest of the circuit. Either a wire is cut in the circuit, or the riversing light switch is locked in the open position. To test the continuity of the circuit on the riversing light switch, it is necessary to access the switch. The riversing light switch of this vehicle is mounted on the left side of the gearbox. Turn the ignition on. Select reverse gear. Connect a test lamp to an earth point. Probe each of the reversing light switch terminals. If the lamp lights on both terminals, the switch is good. The fault is between the switch and reversing lights. If the lamp does not light on any of the two terminals, the switch is not powered. The fault is in the wiring between the fuse and switch. If the lamp only lights on one terminal, the switch is broken and must be replaced. Another way to test the switch is to shunt the connector with the paper clip. Disconnect the switch connector. Turn the ignition on. Shunt the switch terminals with the paper clip. If the reversing lights come on, the wiring is continuous and the switch is broken. If the reversing lights do not come on, the fault is between the switch and reversing lights or between the fuse and reversing lights. The failure of reversing lights always on is easier. Turn the ignition on and shift to neutral to open the switch. There are three ways to test the switch. Probe each of the switch terminals. If the lamp lights on each terminal, the switch is locked in the closed position and must be replaced. Disconnect the connector. If the reversing lights go out, the switch is locked in the closed position and must be replaced. Measure the resistance across the switch. If the resistance is zero, the switch is broken and must be replaced. To replace the switch, place a drain pan under it as oil will flow from the gearbox when the switch is removed. Get ready to quickly refit the new switch to limit oil flow. Remove the switch. Refit the new switch. Refit the connector. Check the reversing lights for correct operation. Refit the front wheel arch liner and the wheel. Remove the filler cap. Add gearbox oil until the oil overflows. Refit the filler cap.